In this video, we're going to talk about oil skimmers, what they are, how they work, when you should use them, and how they apply to environmental management. G'day Brett, how are you?
Very well, thank you.
So let's talk about oil skimmers. I think when I think of a skimmer, I think of a skimmer of a pool box. This is something else entirely.
Yeah, skimmers used to take oil off water in an industrial site or in a marine site, the ocean, seas, lakes.
So on land and on sea?
On land, yeah, in a sump. Like in an industrial site, there'd be a sump right. with oil on top of water. The skimmer will take the oil off the water.
So I wasn't too far off with my pool question.
You're very close.
Okay, good. So talk to me, what are some of the major types of skimmers?
Okay, there's a lot of different types, but the drum skimmer we find is the best. It takes 95% oil and only 5% water. It's very simple to use. It's got floating rollers mm-hmm. that actually take the oil off the water mm-hmm. and act as flotation as well. So they're very simple, but very good to use.
So this is the sort of thing that should be part of a spill kit. I mean, where do you keep these things?
In an industrial situation, they just sit in the sump mm-hmm. or sit in the drain.
Okay.
But in a marine situation, you'd have them on board your boat or close to a marina, very close to the shore.
So these could be actually operating fairly consistently as well as in sort of spill emergencies.
Absolutely. They're ready to go with a power pack and a pump. So yeah, they need to go straight away.
Okay, good. So let's talk about the timing in terms of the best use of oil skimmer. Let's say something happens, something is spilled on water, on land. What kind of time do you have to actually deploy these things?
You've got to react very quickly. First, you've got to contain the spill using the booms, but then the skimmers go into it. Take the, as I said, they sit in the oil that is contained, rotate and pull the oil off the water.
Okay, good. Now, another question I have therefore is about the training here. If you've got to be so quick, surely you should be doing this stuff before you need to be doing this stuff.
Certainly. The training comes into it, and people should be using these all the time before a spill occurs. So every 3 to 6 months, all your crew, on, especially on board a boat, should be trained in the use of the boom and the skimmers.
All right, good. Are there? I want to say there's so many different types. You've mentioned the drum oil skimmer. Are there any others? What's sort of the best type that you recommend, or is it one size fits all?
There is a weir skimmer too, which is good in big wave situations, but it tends to take a bit more water on board, but still a good skimmer. Mm. But we find the drum skimmer tends to be the go-to all-purpose skimmer because of the 95 to 5%.
Okay. And finally, let me ask you about capacity. I imagine that there are big and small skimmers because at some point or other they get full and have to be emptied. How does that work?
No, the skimmer actually works with the pump. So, but there are from small skimmer to a very large skimmer, it'll take 30 cubic metres an hour of oil off water.
Wow.
It depends on the pump that it's using and also your transportation to the containment.
Okay.
So you need large containment as well.
So you then, the actual skimmer then pumps whatever that it's found away and out to be dealt with, is that correct?
Yeah,
through a pipe or something like that?
In a boat situation, it'll put it on the boat or into a bladder. You can use a floating bladder that the oil will actually be pushed into the bladder and fill it up and we'll float it away.
Okay, now that makes a lot of sense. Good. Anything else that we need to know about oil skimmers, critical information?
They've got to be there. You've got to have them ready to go. And as we've said, people have got to be trained in the use of them.
So Brett, let me ask you, I know there are a lot of different kinds of skimmers. How do you match the different sorts of skimmers to different applications?
Different skimmers depending on the wave action for a start, how far away from the land you are, mm-hmm. what sort of currents are happening, and the viscosity of the oil. You've got a drum skimmer, you've got a weir skimmer, and it really, you've got to work out the viscosity, what type of oil, from a bunker oil to a very light sheen oil. So each application needs a different skimmer.
Sounds like you should arguably get a bit of advice as you're setting up these things to make sure you've got the right thing at the right time.
Yeah, absolutely. And you should have enough equipment there to know that if it is a bunker spill or it is a diesel spill, that you've got the right skimmer.
All right, good. Thank you so much. For those of you who'd like to find out more, please join us online at bulbeckenviro.com.au or just reach out, send us an email, give us a call. We'd be more than happy to help and to answer all of your questions.